thanks for tuning in this week. This week, we're talking about home security. And with me, I have Glenn Mathis, who's our Vice President of Global Client Services and Solutions. Hi, Glenn. Thanks for joining us.
How are you?
Good, thanks. How are you?
Doing great. Great.
If it's not a case of just simply having your hardware and software in place, what are the risks that we really need to be mindful of in the remote working environment?
Yeah, good question. I think a secure method of accessing required resources is going to be essential to facilitating remote workers. So, we've seen, as I've said many times, we've seen organizations make the mistake of lowering their level of security surrounding remote access to facilitate those remote workers. And that's a big, big mistake. For example, some companies are relaxed or even removed multi-factor authentication for remote users. And that just makes it a lot easier for hackers to get into the environment without having to have multiple layers of authentication. And once they're in, they can then penetrate beyond just that local environment and move into the work office as well. So we've seen a lot of challenges there. I think the other thing that that we've seen is home Wi-Fi and wired networks is another big difference for remote users. And so those networks are typically not as well secured as networks in the office. And so you see a variety of challenges there. And again, hackers use those less secure environments to find ways in. And then once in, if you're connected into your work environment, they have access to that environment. So that's a challenge. And outside of that, many of the same risks that you would find in the office, you're going to find in the home environment as well. So as I said, phishing can occur. And in fact, they're finding more and more intuitive ways in which to trick people into clicking on the wrong things. Accessing the wrong information, and by way of doing that, they open themselves up to vulnerabilities.
So we've talked a lot about security on the home network and what to look out for with phishing attacks on the increase, as well as collaboration tools. But if we think more kind of broadly about the remote work environment, what else should businesses be thinking about to ensure business continuity?
Well, like I said, I think testing is really important. You have to know what your plan is. You have to also predict. It's hard to predict, and nobody could ever have predicted something like this pandemic. But now that we're in it, I think it's fairly feasible to think that we're going to have more and more of these waves. So testing and making sure that you're prepared for when you have to go back to remote work. More and more companies are just staying at home, but some have tried to go back to work. Knowing that you may have to go home is something you should test. I think the other piece of it too is ensuring that you have have a plan of attack relative to the hardware and software that you're using. Too many companies are relying on the home user to provide the equipment, right? So it's whether it's a bring your own device or utilizing whatever is at home, those are dangerous. And so we recommend that you have a standard, an opinion, on what you're able to provide your employees and plan for that today. Equipment in particular is hard to come by. And so planning for that and making sure you're storing it and having it available allows you to create a standard, which in having a standard allows you to be more effective in the measures that you put in place to secure it. So a plan, that's the kind of the simplest way to put it. Have a plan. Most of these companies that struggled didn't have one.
So flipping to then conversely to the office environment, so we're expected to see about a third of employees continue to work from home permanently post-pandemic, and many businesses simply aren't going to be returning to work in 2020, like the likes of Google and Twitter and so forth. So what do you think that the future office environment is going to look like?
I think more and more people are starting to realize that just how effective people can be working remotely. I've heard many, many companies before the pandemic occurred where they were against the idea of people working remotely. And because they were afraid of losing productivity, they're afraid of not being able to manage the employee. But with being forced to really be nimble and figure this out, I think a lot of companies were really surprised at how effective their employees really could be and how efficient it is to manage the business this way. In fact, some cases there's greater productivity by people working from home. So I think it's going to change significantly. I think companies are starting to figure out what does it cost to manage and to support a user in a brick and mortar office. And I think they're going to look to spend those dollars a little differently, whether it's in purchasing equipment for remote users or increasing their security or their testing or their third party testing of those environments. I think they're going to spend that money a little differently versus you know, what they had to do in rent and in having office equipment and supplies and, you know, kitchen equipment and food and all the things that they were doing before. And so I think they'll look at how they spend that money differently, knowing that the productivity is just as high, if not higher.
So with IT spend on the decrease and security challenges on the rise, what would your recommendations be to a CEO or a CFO as they're considering their technology spend for the next 6 to 12 months?
I think I would tell a CEO or a CIO, CTO to not necessarily cut their spend, but take the money, the budget that they were spending on things like infrastructure and repurpose it to the tip of the spear, being security, cloud, collaboration. I think those are going to be really critical. And so the more that they spend in those areas, the more and more companies are born into the cloud, the more and more we're seeing the movement from physical infrastructure to software as a service or infrastructure as a service in the cloud, even application platform as a service. We should be spending more of our time and money on the data components of that. And so how do you secure that data? Where is that data sitting? That's where we should be focusing our time. What is the security of the applications? How do we leverage that data for better reporting and data-driven decision-making? Those are critical components of the future. How much equipment you have in the office, how much you're spending on having a worker in the office, those are less important. Servers on-prem, less important. Focus on the data components of it, because that's where the world is shifting.
So thank you for tuning in this week. For more information, head to Rethink the Future of Work, where we've got loads of information about how we're tackling the return to work, remote work, and then home security as well. Thank you again.
Giving shape to ideas. Konica Minolta.